Presidential spokesperson and President Duterte's chief legal counsel, Salvador Panao, wrote a letter to him recommending executive clemency for ex-Calawan Mayor Antonio Sanchez. As I earlier said in the press briefing this morning, those articles are reeking with not only responsibility, but with malice. And it is libelous in nature because it imputes an act to discredit me in public and to tarnish my honor. In view of this, I'm filing a libel case against Inquirer, and the Rappler for publishing these malicious articles.
When will that be, sir?
Immediately. We're drafting now the complaint.
So by tomorrow?
Let's see if we can finish it.
Sir, what kind of cyber libel?
Cyber libel at the same time. The regular libel.
So what should be the right word? Because you're saying it's recommended. Apparently you're opposing.
No, as I said earlier, the document speaks for itself. It was referred. In other words, the application was referred to the Bureau of Pardons and Parole for their evaluation. We have nothing to do with it. So in fact, even Senator Gordon, so ni-refer lang pala. So, but they're writing an article saying that I recommended. I did not.
Sir, sakaling i-retract nila yan, sir,
Well, I demanded rectification from Net Inquirer, but I have not received any word from them.
Sir, but
I sent a text earlier about, I think just before the press briefing. I also texted Pia, and I told her no intervention. I explained to her, but she has not responded. She just said, got it. And then I understand she's again writing an article about trying to make an innuendo about the Sanchez family coming here as if we're that close. As I said, 27 years ago, I was one of the lawyers. And there was absolutely no family ties or friendship between us and them.
Sir, but with that mere choice, or even wrong choice of word, perhaps could merit a libel?
Yes, because people now will, in fact, people are saying now that I really did something about the so-called release. In the first place, the letter was not even in reference to Republic Act 10592. It refers to their applying for clemency. Nothing to do with the present controversy.
Okay.
I think it's about time that people like you, because me too, I was a broadcast journalist, I never wrote articles that will cast aspersion or impute any crime or defect or vice to any person, whether natural or juridical. And it's about time we put a stop to this. We should be writing accurately. Because, as we say in law, res ipsa loquitur, the thing speaks for itself. The letters expressly says, I'm just referring the letter. And when they said it was denied, I said, thank you for your prompt response. Nothing more.
Sir, why do you think yung family niya, dun sa letter kasi nakalagay na we'll treat this with confidentiality and as former client,
I know. You know, to be very frank with you, I didn't even read the entire letter because if you will go to the, in fact, I brought some folders. If you will go to my office, you will see so many letters piled up. I have no time to be reading everything, the attachment. When I read about a request for this and that, I just refer it immediately to the lawyers. It's the lawyer who is assigned to do the thing, to do the research.
Even if it was a former client?
It doesn't matter to me because, you know, as I said, you cannot discriminate. Otherwise, you will also be accused of discriminating just because you were a former lawyer of 27 years. You cannot be acting in it when the policy of the president is precisely, you have to respond to all. Wala tayong pipiliin dito. Pag may sumulat, sagutin nyo. That's it.
Sir, ano lang, doon sa Senate hearing,
yes.
The plan of the Department of Justice Secretary to reorder or to rearrest yung mga napalayang mga convicted criminals of heinous crimes, with what will the executive do as to help them relocate those inmates who are now at large after being released because of the GCTA?
Well, we will have to defer to the Department of Justice what it will do with them, because that's properly their territory.
I think Justice Secretary Guevara committed to Senator Lacson to rearrest those who are wrongfully released because of the wrong implementation of the GCTA law.
Yes, from the very start, that was why I said, if you recall, I said there should be a rearrest because they were not qualified in the first place. The theory advanced by one lawyer who said that you cannot do that because it's a penal law, it should retroact and benefit the inmates, because since you already granted release, an erroneous interpretation of law cannot be invoked. And my response to that is, in the first place, they are not qualified. In other words, they did not follow the law. So can there be a basis for so-called you can no longer invoke?
Sir, last point. Any announcement of Duterte firing Feldon?
No, as I said earlier, when I talked to the president last night, he said, I will wait for the investigation of the Senate. That's what he said.
So whatever will be the recommendation of the Senate?
He didn't say whatever. Well, what he said is, I will wait for the investigation to be finished, and I'll wait for the recommendation before I make my decision.
Sir, si Presidente, may specific orders ba kay former General Melegrito, who was designated deputy view board chief?
I have no info on that.
Can you check on that?
Well, I'll ask you when we have our cabinet meeting tomorrow.
So, sir, once the warrants of arrest ay na-issue at hindi nahuli at ma-surrender, they could be considered as fugitives.
Ganun nga mangyari kung may warrant of arrest.
Okay. So we will wait for the announcement.
We'll just wait for whatever announcement the president will make on the matter.
Sir, arrest na, dadaling lahat sa court, kulit yan?
Yung alam.
Ay,
kung may warrant of arrest, hindi, siyempre mayroong return ng warrant. Di sa court pa rin pupunta.
Sir, court ang
I will not be able to respond to that. Whatever the Secretary of Justice will do on this matter, we will leave it to him. In the first place, it was not a referral letter to act favorably. The letter speaks for itself. It was an ordinary referral to them to do something about the request. That's for them to decide. But we have nothing to do with it.
But the congressman said that it is no ordinary letter, because as presidential legal counsel and spokesperson, it definitely carries weight and he has the ear of the president.
Oh, definitely there is no, in this administration, there is no such thing as influential person to the president. The president is very strict on just follow the law, whatever the law. Precisely, his instruction is to respond to all letters regardless. Hindi kayo dapat mamili. Kung sino sumula, tulungan natin. I-refer niyo sa mga appropriate agency. Bahala na yung appropriate agency kung dapat tulungan o hindi.
Sir, pero hindi ba kayo worried na minsan may mga, alam mo na, medyo naive, medyo tanga na mga nasa ahensya. Isipin nila the mere logo of the office of the president and the mere name of a Salvador Panelo, a presidential
candidate. I do not think so, because
would consider it as misconstrued as endorsement.
No, I do not think so. In the first place, it is referred to the heads of the departments. Mm-hmm. They are responsible and competent and intelligent enough. Secondly, they know the policy of the president. No such influence whatsoever coming from any one of us. Mm-hmm. Actually, I have that now that you are saying that to me, it's only now that because I said I do not read the entire letter. When I see that it's a request, pinapasa ko kagad sa mga abogado kung sino ang assign.
But did you not parang nag-doubt na bakit
No, but precisely, I didn't read the entire letter. Pag nabasa ko lang na nagre-request ng clemency, diretso na yan kung sino ko bugadong i-assign ko. There are three lawyers. Eh. So I just assign.
Nabasa niyo lang sana, sir, na may nakalagay doon na confidentiality. Tingin niyo, i-refer
niyo pa ba? Hindi, siguro sasagutin ko siya. Sasagutin ko siya na irrelevant lahat siya. Basta, I'll just refer your request.
So yung letter, did you also refer it to the office of then presidential advisor Bongo and the president?
No.
Kasi it is specifically mentioned.
No. I just refer it to the... Kasi if you will notice, this is where I wanted you to go up. Kasi palagi nilang refer it to the appropriate authority or kaya the Bureau of Pardons and Parole. Puro ganun lang ang sinasabi ko.
Sir, pero
palaging respond and then refer. Oh, hindi nga. As I said, hindi, we cannot discriminate regardless of whatever letter coming from whom. We have to respond. Kung ano yung hinihingi nila, o hindi-refer namin, bahala sila kung sinong gustong gumawa ng aksyon. But kami, sa opisina, wala kaming authority, wala kaming mandate. Our job is just to respond. To refer to the appropriate agencies.
Sir, pero sa totoo lang, hindi ba mo ba naisip kahit saglit na nung pakakita mo yung pangalang Sanchez tapos i-refer mo, iba ka pag-usapan, maging controversial.
Eh, unang-una malinis ang konsyensya ko. Pangalawa, 27 years ago pa, hindi ko man siya nakikita. So, ordinary sa akin lahat yung konsyensya. Sinong lumapit, sinasagot ko.
Sir, nung nag-usap kayo ni Miss Marie Mimi Sanchez,
yung
anak, anong
bigay nyo na? Wala, kung ano yung sinabi ko sa inyo, sabi ko, ganyan ang batas ay susundin natin dito. Yeah, kung meron ng desisyon, ang gusto nagre-request kayo, dire-refer ko doon sa opisinang nag-aaral kung anong pwedeng dapat gawin sa letter niya. Yun lang. And that took us a few minutes.
Gano'n raw ka-importante sana na ma-pardon yung tatay?
Ano no?
Gano'n raw ka-importante sa kanila na ma-pardon sila?
Wala namang binigay. Basta inano lang yung letter nila na nag-a-apply sila. Pardons and parole.
Yes, sir. Did you think na yung referral letter could have put pressure doon sa
no.
Corrections because of the weight that the weight na you can carry the signature niyo also?
No. In the first place, my name does not carry a weight because precisely the president's policy to all of us, paulit-ulit niya sinasabi, walang sacred cow dito. Nakita niyo kung paano ko mag-fire. Kaya lahat kami, alam na namin yon. Walang makaka-impluwensya kahit kanino.
Sir, matanong ko lang, sir, hanggang ngayon ba naniniwala kayo inosente si
Mr. Sanchez? Yan ang problema. Hindi, I cannot also respond to that because baka bilagyan na naman ang kulay. So, since wala naman ako dyan, tapos na, may decision ng korte. And all lawyers always respect the decision of the court. Ganyan na yan eh.
Okay.
Thank you.